This is Tennis Now. Novak Djokovic routs Roger Federer in an exhibition match. Serena Williams, Andy Murray, Samantha Stosur, and more top pros return to action next week in Australia. Maria Sharapova, Caroline Wozniacki, and Serena Williams are among Yahoo's most searched athletes. And Spain appoints Arantxa Sánchez Vicario as its new Fed Cup captain. All of this and more on Tennis Now. Welcome to Tennis Now's twice-a-week news update show, where we've got all you need to know about what's going on in tennis. I'm James Watterson, and we are just a few days away from the start of the 2012 season. Today we've got a preview of that, plus Djokovic routed Federer in an exhibition in Abu Dhabi, Spain named Arantxa Sánchez Vicario as its new Fed Cup captain, and so much more. Now, before I get to the news today, I wanted to mention that we are at the end of our week of new racket reviews. So far, we've reviewed Federer's new Wilson 6190 BLX, Juan Martín Del Potro's Juice Pro BLX, as well as Yonex's new line of rackets, so make sure to head over to tennisnow.com to check them out. We'll put links in the video description below. Novak Djokovic routed Roger Federer 6-2, 6-1 in the semifinals of the World Tennis Championships exhibition in Abu Dhabi on Friday. The world number one showed much finer form than he did against Gael Monfils on Thursday, when the Frenchman pushed him to three sets. He got an early lead in both sets and dominated play throughout, ultimately wrapping up the match in 44 minutes. After the match, Djokovic said people should not read too much into the result because he had a match under his belt, while Federer hadn't played since he won the ATP World Tour Finals in November. The Serb moves on to face David Ferrer, who dismissed Rafael Nadal 6-3, 6-2. Yesterday, Ferrer outlasted Jo-Wilfried Tsonga in three sets, so like Djokovic, he may have been a little bit better prepared. Looking ahead to the final, Djokovic has a 6-5 record against Ferrer, but he lost their last match at the World Tour Finals in straight sets. Federer will also take on Nadal in the consolation match. The winner of the six-man winner-take-all tournament will take home $250,000. Good news for tennis fans, the new season starts next week. A star-studded lineup, including Serena Williams, defending Australian Open champion Kim Clijsters, Andy Murray, and Gilles Simon, will play at the Brisbane International. It will be a welcome return to Australia for Serena, who was dealing with some serious health issues at the beginning of this year. She hasn't played Down Under since 2010, when she beat Justine Henin to win the Australian Open. Clijsters is on her way back as well after suffering a series of injuries that sidelined her enough to see her ranking drop outside of the top 10. Apparently, she is healthy, and she'll need to be at the top of her game to defend her title from earlier this year. On the men's side, Andy Murray will look to play his way through a draw that includes Bernard Tomic and Keenish Corey. Meanwhile, the Hotman Cup boasts an impressive set of players. World number one Caroline Wozniacki, Petra Kvitova, Li Na, Tomas Berdych, and Fernando Verdasco are all playing in the team mixed doubles event, which should be quite entertaining. Finally, Sabina Lisicki, Flavia Pennetta, and Svetlana Kuznetsova will play for the title in Auckland. You can follow all of these results on our live scores page at tennisnow.com. Caroline Wozniacki, Serena Williams, and Maria Sharapova are among the top 10 most searched athletes on yahoo.com in 2011. Wozniacki, the world number one, came in at 10th in the list. This year, she won six titles, including Indian Wells, reached the semifinals of the Australian Open and the US Open, and she posted a 63-17 record for the year. She is also in a high-profile relationship with top-ranked golfer Rory McIlroy, which has brought her even more media attention. Williams came in at number 5, and Sharapova finished at 4th in the list. The Russian was the most searched for athlete on Yahoo in 2005 and 2008. Although she didn't have the Grand Slam success of years past, she won in Rome and she reached the Wimbledon final. Forbes named Sharapova as the highest-paid female athlete in the world with $25 million in prize money earnings and endorsements. Manny Pacquiao, Tiger Woods, and Danica Patrick finished above Sharapova on the list, while Kobe Bryant, Chris Humphries, and Hope Solo also made the list. Former world number one and four-time Grand Slam champion Arantxa Sánchez Vicario was named as Spain's new Fed Cup captain on Wednesday. Sánchez Vicario signed a two-year agreement with the Spanish Tennis Federation, and she will lead the team when it faces Russia in February. The 40-year-old holds Spain's record for the match wins at 72, singles wins at 50, and with Conchita Martinez, doubles wins at 18. She was also an integral part of the Spanish team that won five Fed Cup titles in the 1990s. She said, quote, "I thank the Federation and Albert Costa, who is now the Spanish national team coordinator, for giving me this opportunity." Her appointment comes one day after the Spanish Tennis Federation appointed Alex Correia as Spain's Davis Cup captain. And that'll do it from us. Remember to check us out at tennisnow.com to stay informed about what's going on in tennis, and follow us on Facebook and Twitter for up-to-the-minute updates. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can see when we put up new news shows, instruction, and more. As always, thank you for watching, and have a happy new year.